FTP is another way you can use to access your files on your web host. In this video, we are going to use FTP to upload WordPress instead of the cPanel. Whether you use FTP or the cPanel really comes down to personal preference. To allow us to set up our FTP access, we first need the configuration settings. We can get these by going to the cPanel and clicking on FTP accounts. This area here is used to create a new FTP account. This is useful if you have multiple websites on your web host, but want to limit someone's access to only one of the websites. Since you own the web host, you don't want to have any restrictions. So what we're going to do is scroll down to the bottom to where it says Special FTP Accounts. There you should see the username that you use to log into your cPanel. On the right hand side, click on Configure FTP Client. This will show you the settings you need to put into your FTP client to be able to connect to your web server. Now I'm going to minimize my web browser to go to my FTP client. The FTP client I use and recommend is FileZilla, and I've put a link to this program in the description below. Once you open FileZilla, click on this little button here. This will bring up the site manager. The site manager is where you can insert your FTP configuration settings. As you can see, I've already got FTP set up for 3 different websites. Yours should just be blank. Click on New Site and name it. I'm going to name mine peterstavro.com, so I know that these FTP settings are used to connect to my peterstavro.com website. Here's where I'm going to enter the configuration settings which we previously saw on the cPanel. Once you've entered your settings, click on Connect. Okay, here we go. We have just connected to the web host. As you can see, there's nothing in there yet, but that is where we're going to upload our WordPress file. To upload it, go to your WordPress file and simply drag it into this box. Down here, you will see your WordPress file being uploaded to your web host. Once it's finished uploading, you will see it here. You can also check if your upload was successful by clicking on this tab here. Here you can see your successful upload history. Okay, so we have now successfully uploaded the file using FTP, but it is still zipped. The most reliable way to unzip the file is to follow the steps we used in the previous video. Go back to your cPanel. Click on File Manager and press Go. As you can see, the WordPress file you just uploaded using FTP is here. Click on it and click on Extract, then click on Extract Files. Again, once the WordPress zip has been extracted, you can go ahead and delete it to save space on your web server. Press reload and voila, the folder is there. We now just need to move the files into the public_HTML directory like we did in the previous video.